Hi everyone, my name is Fanindra and in this video I am going to explain about erythroblastosis fetalis. I am going to explain the theoretical part and diagrammatic part of this erythroblastosis fetalis. Firstly, let us go ahead with the theoretical part so that you can clearly understand the diagram which I have been represented on this paper. So firstly, we have to understand what is the definition of this erythroblastosis fetalis. Actually, it's a kind of a disease which you can see in the fetus, once it is growing in the womb of a mother. So, transplacental transmission of maternal antibodies to fetal red blood cells leads to hemolytic anemia in the fetus. So, this is the definition of the erythroblastosis fetalis. I hope you haven't understood about this definition. So, let us go into deep so that you can clearly understand the behind scenes of this definition. So, we know that there are two types of blood groups in human beings, which you can see in the human beings. Rh blood group type and ApO blood group type. In the case of Rh blood group type, there are total of 49 antigens. In the case of ABO blood group type, we can see three kind of antigens like A antigen, B antigen and AB antigen. Whereas in the case of O type of blood group, we cannot see any kind of antigen, but we can see only antibodies. So in the case of Rh antigens, there are totally of 49 antigens which I have told you. Among these 49 antigens, 5 of them are really very very important which you people have to remember. Capital D, capital C, small c, capital E and small e. So these are the antigens of Rh blood group type. And among these 5, RhD antigen will play a crucial role in the process of the occurrence of erythroblastosis fetalis. So one of the most important point which you people have to remember is that, so we know that A antigen, if you are going to take a person X and that person will be having, let's consider two type of persons where one of the person will be having a blood group of A positive and another person will be having a blood group of A negative, right? So similarly, we'll be having B positive and B negative, AB positive and AB negative. So in the case of A positive kind of human being, he will be having A plus antigens. So similarly, he will be also having RhD antigens also. But if you're going to take another person with A negative blood group, then he will be having A antigens, but there is a lack of RhD antigens. So this is one of the most important point which you people have to remember. And in the case of this RhD antigens, definitely to undergo the process of anything, then it lead to interact with the antibodies. So there are antibodies called as RhD antibodies. And sometimes some people will refer that as Rh anti-D antibodies. Don't forget, both are same. Okay. So there will be interaction between this RhD antigen and RhD antibodies. And that reaction process will be occurred by hemolytic transfusion. So this hemolytic transfusion is a process which occurs in the placenta, which will help this RhD antibodies to get interacted with this RhD antigens, which will lead to hemolytic disease of the fetus. And that disease is called as erythroblastosis fetalis. So this is how the process which is present behind in order to occur, the disease is called as erythroblastosis fetalis. So this is what the scenario which is present behind the scenes. So now let us go ahead with the definition clearly. So when an Rh negative woman conceives an Rh positive fetus, which means, let's say her blood group is Rh negative, okay, and the fetus which is growing in her womb is Rh positive blood group type. So let us consider this as a scenario. So if that is a scenario, then it will lead to hemolytic transfusion, because the Rh positive fetus, the blood will enter into the placenta of Rh negative woman. So which means there will be a kind of a diffusion which occurs, but we know that there will be no interaction between antigens there will be only interaction between antigen and antibodies, right? So that will lead to hemolytic transfusion and will cause heavy risk of hemolytic disease of the fetus called as erythroblastosis fetalis. That's what I have explained you here, right? So one of the most important point which you people have to remember is that there will be two kind of pregnancies which you can see in that particular woman. In the case of first pregnancy, though there will be a presence of this Rh positive antigens in the fetus, it doesn't cause any harm to the fetus and the delivery of the baby will be very safe, but only in the scenario of the first pregnancy. Once if the couple will be having sex again and that will lead to second pregnancy, then definitely that will cause severe risk to that particular fetus, and even though if the delivery of the baby in the case of second pregnancy is safe, definitely he will be infected with this disease called as erythroblastosis fetalis. And sometimes that will also lead to the death of the fetus. Okay, so this is what I would like to explain to you, something theoretical about this erythroblastosis fetalis. And let us also have a look about the symptoms of this erythroblastosis fetalis. In the case of symptoms, the first one is swollen, pale or jaundice after birth. So, I mean, if the delivery is safe, definitely he will be infected with the erythroblastosis fetalis only in the case of second pregnancy. And these are the symptoms which you can see if the delivery is successful with the infection of this erythroblastosis fetalis: swollen, pale or jaundice after birth. So when compared to normal infants, these people will be having larger liver or spleen, and they will be also infected with the disease called as anemia. So you know what is anemia? Low count of red blood cells, that leads to anemia. So these are the three important symptoms which you can see in a fetus once if the delivery is safe, though he will be infected with this erythroblastosis fetalis. So now let us understand this process of the erythroblastosis fetalis in a diagrammatic form. So now we have understood the theoretical information about this erythroblastosis fetalis. So now let us go ahead with the diagrammatic form so that you can clearly understand how the process of this erythroblastosis fetalis occurs. And in this situation, consider two scenarios, pregnancy 1 and pregnancy 2. Because I have already told you that the delivery of the baby in the case of pregnancy 1 will be very safe. But in the case of pregnancy 2, it is very risky. So how it is risky? Let us have a clear look about that. So in the case of first pregnancy, so I have told you, let's consider this as a body of mother. And let us consider this area as a fetus. Okay. So we know that in the case of mother, I have told you how the process of this erythroblastosis fetus, this disease will be initiated. How? Because if the mother is having Rh negative antigens in her red blood cells, on the surface of her red blood cells, and if the fetus will be having Rh positive antigens on his or her red blood cells, then that will lead to erythroblastosis fetalis. So let's consider this as a placenta, and there will be interaction of this blood, Rh negative blood group type and Rh positive blood group type. Both of these antigens will move across the placenta, but they will not be mixed, because we know that there will be no interaction between antigen and antigen. There will be only interaction between antigen and antibody. So the blood will be passed out from the fetus to the mother by the open placenta. So in the process of this time, there will be a delivery of the baby, and that delivery of the baby will be very safe, because there is no such kind of interaction, antigen and antibody interaction, because there is only antigen and antigen interaction, but not antibody interaction, right? So that's the reason the delivery of the pregnancy 1, and in the case of scenario of pregnancy 1, the delivery of the fetus will be very, very, very safe. There is no risk in that. But remember, the blood cells, the Rh positive antigens which are present on the surface of the red blood cells of this fetus have been entered into the placenta of this mother. Into the bloodstream of the mother. Okay. So it has been entered. Now leave this pregnancy 1 scenario, because the delivery has been very, very safe. But make sure that the antigens have been entered into the bloodstream of the mother. Now what will be happening? Now let us take the second scenario, which is pregnancy 2. It is very, very risky. In the case of this pregnancy 2, consider the same mother, but the couple have took the sex again, which led to the second pregnancy. So let's consider the fetus will be having again Rh plus antigens on the surface of his or her red blood cells. So similarly, Rh negative antigens will also be present. But as I have told you, there are presence of antigens which have been entered into the mother, into the bloodstream of the mother. So what will be happening? Definitely the antibodies will be released against to those antigens, right? So now what will be happening? That antibodies will enter into the bloodstream of the fetus. So once those antibodies will enter into the bloodstream of the fetus, all these antibodies will get interacted with the antigens, right? Antigens of Rh positive antigens of fetus. So once the interaction will be done, so that will lead to hemolytic disease of the fetus. And that hemolytic disease is nothing but erythroblastosis fetalis. Then this particular fetus will be infected with this disease called as erythroblastosis fetalis. And then the delivery of the pregnancy, the scenario of pregnancy 2 will be done. But that is very, very risky. Sometimes that fetus will lead to death. And sometimes, though the delivery is successful, that infant, I mean, that baby will be infected with this erythroblastosis fetalis. But we can see the symptoms. And those symptoms I have already told you, like swollen, pale or jaundice, which you can see after birth of that baby. Or else, when compared to other babies, his liver will be very, very large and his spleen will also be very large. And we can also see that baby who is suffering with anemia, which means less count of RBC cells in his blood. So this kind of things which you can see. So this is about the erythroblastosis fetalis and how the occurrence of this erythroblastosis fetalis will be happen. I hope this theoretical knowledge and practical knowledge have been gained by you people. And if yes, please subscribe to my channel and also press the bell icon for the latest updates. And you can also share this video to your friends so that it might be useful for them. Thank you.